We thank the Lord for such a day like this. Did you come with your Bible? Where is the Bible there? You will conquer every problem in Jesus' name. Let's close our eyes for prayer. Father, we thank you for this day. What a wonderful day. It's a day you have made. We rejoice in it in Jesus' name. We bless your name for the program we have tonight. We've come to study your word. We've come to see Jesus. We've come to lift up Jesus. Lord, I pray there'll be a revelation in every heart tonight in Jesus' name. Reveal Jesus in his fullness, in his power, in his glory, and all that he has for everyone, you give us in Jesus' name. Let there be a revelation in every heart. Give us a spirit of understanding. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless everyone. You can sit down. Tonight we're looking at Revelation. And it's in chapter 1. I'm reading 2 verses of the chapter unto you. Chapter 1 of Revelation, verse 7 and verse 8. It says, behold, he cometh. Behold, he cometh. It's like heaven and earth standing at attention. It's like angels and men gazing with surprise. And then he called everybody on earth, everybody all over the world to attention. Behold, stop every other thing. Look at this one. Think about this. Behold, he cometh. Who is that? That's Jesus. He came before for the first time. And when he came at that time, he died on the cross. He came at that time to provide for our salvation. He came at that time to conquer the devil and to conquer sin and to conquer sickness and to conquer every evil. Then he went to heaven after his resurrection. And now we have the announcement. And now we have the proclamation. And now we have the prophetic statement. Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all the kindreds of the earth shall wail, shall cry, shall mourn because of him. Even so, amen. Everybody shout amen. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, says the Lord, which is and which was and which is to come, the Almighty. Tonight, we're looking at those verses of Scripture, and he's talking about the revelation of Christ's second coming. When we say revelation, it means it gives us understanding. The curtain is pushed aside. The veil is taken away. And then there is an uncovering for us to see in prophetic language that the Lord is coming. Our Jesus is coming back again. And when he comes back, he comes to reign. Christ came the first time, and when he came the first time, he made a sacrifice. He surrendered his life. He did everything necessary so that you and I can be saved. But now we're told he's coming the second time. That's why you have that proclamation coming from heaven to everyone on earth. Behold, he cometh. Before he came the first time, there were many prophecies that were spoken. that were revealed about the fact that he was coming. Isaiah said, a virgin shall conceive and shall bring forth a son. His name shall be called Emmanuel. That was prophesied about 700 years before he came, and eventually he came the first time. Isaiah said, unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6. Eventually it came true. Isaiah spoke about his life. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and has anointed me to preach the good news, the good tidings to the poor. He has anointed me to open the eyes of the blind. That was also fulfilled. David said, my God, my God, why have you forsaken me? That's in Psalm 22. It was about his first coming. He said, they pierced my hand and they pierced my feet, and it was fulfilled. Isaiah again tells us that he's a man of sorrows, and then he had grief. He was wounded for a transgression, he was bruised for iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. That was prophecy about his first coming. So as you see the prophecies about his first coming, they were all fulfilled to the letter. When he came the first time, there are many people that did not know he had come, because they were taken by surprise. And yet all the details of the prophecy was fulfilled. And in fact, that woman by the well said, we know the Messiah is coming, and when he comes, he will tell us all things. She didn't know that the Messiah had come, that the prophecy about his first coming had been fulfilled. And then Jesus said, I that speak unto you, I am he. He was revealing that the prophecy concerning his first coming had been fulfilled, just like the first coming of Christ was fulfilled. The prophecies fulfilled in the same way. The second coming of Christ had been prophesied over and over, both in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. And in many passages of Scripture, we have the prophecy and the pronouncement, the prediction and the promise that Christ is coming again. Christ will come again. I said, Christ will come again. The Heavenly Father said so. Jesus himself said so. The angels said so. And the prophets prophesied it, that Jesus is coming again. Actually, in this book of Revelation, you'll find the pronouncement of his coming, that he's coming again. You'll find it seven times. Look at this. I'm looking at chapter 1, verse 7. Behold, he cometh with the clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all the kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, everybody, amen. That's the first time you find in the book of Revelation telling us that there's Christ who came the first time to suffer for you, to die for you, to save you, to heal you, to deliver you. Now he was buried after his crucifixion, and then he rose again, and then he went to heaven. Now the announcement comes in chapter 1 of Revelation. Behold, he cometh. Look at chapter 2. In chapter 2, I'm reading from verse 25. Chapter 2, verse 25. It tells us, but that which ye have already, hold fast till I come. Here is the Lord Jesus himself assuring us, emphasizing and proclaiming that he is coming. He says, until I come. Look at chapter 3, and I'm reading from verse 11. Chapter 3, verse 11. Behold, I come quickly. That's the third time, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, telling us that this Christ who went to heaven, that is coming again. And he says, behold, look at this, think about this, stop every other thing, and then meditate on the fact that Christ is coming again. I come quickly, hold that fast which thou hast, that nobody will take your crown. Nobody will take your crown. Number fourth time, we're looking at chapter 16 and in verse 15. Chapter 16, verse 15. Behold, I come. You see that over and over, that there will be no shadow of doubt in anyone that Christ is coming again. He himself pronounced, I come. I come, I come, he's coming again. Behold, I come as a thief. What does that mean? He'll come suddenly. He'll come unannounced. He's coming certainly. And he's coming to take the precious people, his own people, away from the earth. That's why he says, behold, I come as a thief. He says, blessed is he that watches and keepeth his garments, lest he walk naked and they see his shame. I pray you'll be among the blessed at that day. Give me a good delta. Amen. Look at chapter 22. Chapter 22, I read from verse 7. This is a feast time now. Behold, I come quickly. Have you noticed that he is the one making the announcement? He's the one assuring you, I'm coming again. He is the one emphasizing, repeating it over and over. He said, don't doubt this, because his word is true. Heaven and earth may pass away, but his word shall not pass away. Behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book. Look at verse 12. Sixth time now. Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be. That's the sixth time. The seventh time, look at verse 20. He which testifies these things says, surely I come quickly. And everybody said, amen. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. You'll find then, as you look at the book of Revelation, it's giving us a revelation. It's giving us something certain, something sure, something you cannot doubt, something that will definitely happen. And Christ is coming again. That's why we're looking at the message tonight, the revelation of Christ's second coming. I divide the study to three parts. Number one, we're looking at number one, the revelation of his sure return. The revelation of his sure return is revealed to us, and it is sure, and it is certain. I pray you will not miss it in Jesus' name. Give me a good amen. The revelation of his sure coming, of his sure return. Number two, the response and the reaction to his sudden return. When he returns, he comes suddenly. He comes certainly. But he comes with power. He comes with glory. And when he comes like that, there'll be response on the one hand, there'll be a reaction on the other hand. There'll be response from the children of Israel. On the one hand, there'll be a reaction from the Gentiles. On the other hand, there'll be response on the part of the church. On the one hand, there'll be reaction on the part of the world. On the other hand, that's why you have number two, the response and the reaction to his sudden return. Number three now, part three in the study tonight. We're talking about our readiness for the saints' rapture. Our readiness for the saints' rapture. Somebody there will get ready. I said somebody there will get ready. you'll be ready so that you will not miss out on that glorious day in Jesus' name. Christ is coming. And here we're told about the revelation of that sure return. Let's come back to Revelation chapter 1. Revelation chapter 1. And I'm reading from verse 7 again. It says, behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all the kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. I am Alpha and Omega. Is saying that is the first alphabet and the last alphabet, and everything in between, and is the culmination and the climax and the peak of history. And he has the power, he has the knowledge, he has the understanding. And when he says he's coming again, surely he's coming again. It's the beginning and the ending. Have you noticed? He talks about his coming in chapter 1. And then in the middle, he talks about his coming. And then at the end of Revelation, he talks about his coming. Alpha at the beginning, Omega at the end. The beginning and the ending. The certainty, without any shadow of doubt, that Christ is coming again. I am Alpha, I am Omega, and the beginning and the ending, says the Lord, which is alive, which was, he was here before he died, and now he rose again, and he is to come. He is the Almighty. He has the power to do everything he said he will do, and he's coming again. Nothing will stop him. And you will be alive to see his coming. I said you'll be alive to see his coming. And I pray you'll be ready on that final day in Jesus' name. About the coming of the Lord, who said the first time in Revelation chapter 1, when he said he's coming again, did he say that before? Did any other person say that before? That this Christ who has gone to heaven, that is coming again? Let's look at this. Look at John chapter 14. John chapter 14. And we're reading from verse 1. John 14. We're looking at verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. He'll take your trouble away today. All the sorrows he'll take away today. All the pains he'll take away today. I was waiting for a great, great amen. Amen. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. That's what takes your trouble away. When you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, that is your Redeemer, is your Savior. He is the all in all for you. He's your healer. And he's the one that will solve your problem. He's a great miracle worker. Everything he said he will do, and all the good desires of your heart, tonight is your night. He'll fulfill in Jesus' name. Therefore, do not allow your heart to be troubled. All you need to do is believe in God and believe also in him. He says in verse 2, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. That's before he died. I go to prepare a place for you. That's why I went to the cross. That's why I died. That's why I was buried. That's why he rose again. And then after appearing to his own disciples, all those days, 40 days, with infallible proof. And he said, I am he. And then Thomas said, my Lord, my God. And then eventually he went to heaven. That's what he said. I go to prepare a place for you. Look at this one, verse 3. And if I go, after his resurrection, after his ascension, if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. That's the second coming. He assured us he's coming again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye will be also. Was that the only time he spoke about his coming again? Look at Matthew chapter 24. Matthew chapter 24. And here I'm reading from verse 30. Matthew chapter 24. We're looking at verse 30. The assurance that this Christ who died, This Christ who rose again, this Christ who went to heaven, that is going to come back the second time. Matthew chapter 24 and verse 30, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. It will happen. I said it will happen. Look at the assurance in verse 35. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away. He's giving us the assurance that he will come again. He will come again. Why are we studying that? So that we'll not be in ignorance. So that we will know Christ is coming. And then we will need to know what to do to be ready. Thank God you'll be ready. Somebody there said, you'll be ready. When it comes, you'll be ready in Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 25. I'm reading from verse 31. Matthew chapter 25, verse 31. It says, when the Son of Man shall come in his glory. What's that talking about? The second coming. When he came the first time, it was humiliation dispatched on him. He carried the cross. He was sweating of blood in Gethsemane. And then he cried, my God, why have you forsaken me? That was a time of humiliation. But now he's coming again with great glory. It will be the time of great exaltation. That's why he says, when the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him. What is talking about? The second coming. When he came the first time, he was born in the manger the first time. All the holy angels were not there. Only one angel went to those shepherds and they announced that he has come the first time. But when he comes the second time, all the holy angels will be with him. And he says, then shall he sit upon the throne of glory. He will come to reign. Certainly, our Lord is coming again. I said our Lord is coming again. Chapter 8, I'm looking at Mark chapter 8. Mark chapter 8, we're reading from verse 38. It's giving us assurance, and it's talking about the revelation of a sure return. The very fact that Christ is coming again, is coming the second time. Mark chapter 8, verse 38. Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed. Look at this. When he cometh. He's coming. Coming again. Coming the second time. When he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. Matthew recorded it, is coming again. Mark recorded it, is coming again. Does Luke have anything to say about it that is coming again? Look at this in Luke chapter 21. Luke chapter 21, everybody affirms. The writers affirm. The prophets affirm. And they confirm that Christ who went to heaven and Christ who ascended to glory, that is coming back again. We're looking at Luke chapter 21, verse 25. Then shall ye see, shall be the sign in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, upon the earth distress of nations and perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them for fear. And for looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven, of the sky, shall be shaken. Then shall they see, look at this, the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Isn't it wonderful that as you read Matthew, Matthew says it's coming again. As you read Mark, Mark says it's coming again. As you read Luke, Luke says it's coming again. Out of the mouths of two or three witnesses, the truth shall be confirmed. Already we have read in John that he says, I will return and I will come and take you unto myself. Colossians chapter 3. In Colossians chapter 3, we're reading from verse 4. Colossians chapter 3, reading here from verse 4. It says, when Christ, who is our life, shall appear. That's talking about his coming again. It says he's gone to heaven and he's coming back. And it says, when Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also with him appear in glory. If you're a believer, if you're a child of God, you'll appear with him in glory in Jesus' name. Do you know the angels also affirmed and confirmed that he's coming again? Acts of the Apostles chapter 1. Acts of the Apostles chapter 1, I'm reading from verse 9. The assurance that he will come again. The understanding that he will come again. The revelation that he will come again. So that you are getting ready, you are getting prepared. That when he comes, he'll find you ready. You'll be ready in Jesus' name. I said you'll be ready in Jesus' name. Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 9. It says, and when he has spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven, because that's where he went, as he went up, behold, two men, two angels stood by them in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye here? Why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, the one who died, this same Jesus, the one who was buried, and the one who rose the third day, the same Jesus, the same who appeared to his own disciples after his resurrection, the same Jesus, and the one who went up to heaven alive after his resurrection at this time, the same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven. Into heaven. Where is Jesus now? Tell me out loud. In heaven, is taking to heaven, shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go into heaven. That's certain then. That's very sure then that this Jesus, our Lord, is coming again. I said he's coming again. He will save you today, but he's coming again. He will heal you today, but he's coming again. He will deliver you today, but he's coming again. He wants to get you ready. That's why he wants to solve your problems today, so that that day when he comes, you'll be rejoicing, waiting, expecting the coming of the Lord in Jesus' name. Give me a good amen. As you look through the Bible, there are some things that demand that Christ will come again. Number one, the promise of God demands that Christ will come again. There's something God has promised. And because he promised that, and that promise is yet to be fulfilled, that promise of God demands that Christ will come again. In Psalm 2, we're looking at the book of the Psalms. And we're looking at Psalm 2. In Psalm 2, I'm reading from verse 6. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. I will declare the decree. The Lord has said unto me, thou art my son. Capital S is talking about Jesus Christ. This day have I begotten thee. Look at this. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen. And then it goes on to say, for thine inheritance and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. Look at verse 9. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. That has not happened yet. That demands he must come again to make that happen. And then it says that I shall dash them in pieces as a potter's vessel. It's coming to reign. It's coming to rule. That has not happened yet. The promise of God demands that he comes again. Number two, the proclamation of Christ himself demands that he comes again. He must come, because that was his proclamation. When did he proclaim that? A lot of times, a number of times. Already I've read to you when he said, I will go and prepare a place for you, and I will come again. That proclamation of Jesus Christ demands that he must come again. Look at Matthew chapter 26. In Matthew chapter 26, verse 63. And Jesus held his peace, and the high priest answered and said unto him, I adjure thee by the living God that thou tell us whether thou be the Christ, the Son of God. Look at the answer. This is the proclamation of Jesus. In verse 64, Jesus said unto him, thou hast said, nevertheless I say unto you, hereafter ye shall see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of power and coming in the clouds of heaven. The promise of God demands that he comes again, and the proclamation of Christ demand that he come again. The parables of Jesus demand that he come again. He must come again. The parables declare that he went to receive a kingdom and is coming again. And because of that, we know he's coming again. And he spoke about the foolish virgins and the wise virgins in that parable. Now, number four, the precept of Christ demands that he come again. The precept of Christ. What's the precept? Look at Luke chapter 19. In Luke chapter 19, I'm reading from verse 11. Luke chapter 19, and I'm reading here from verse 11. And as they heard these things, he added and spake a parable, because he was near to Jerusalem, and because they thought that the kingdom of God shall come immediately appear. And he said, therefore, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. He went to a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. He's gone to that far country, now he's gone to heaven, and he's going to have the kingdom. He'll be the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And he says, it's so return. Look at his precept. And he called his 10 servants and declared and delivered them £10 and said unto them, tell me out loud, occupy till I come. He gave a precept there. And then he says, keep on doing this, the work of soul winning, until I come. The promise of God demands that Jesus must come again. The proclamation of Christ demands that Jesus must come again. And the parables of Jesus demand that he must come again. The precept of Christ demands that he must come again. The prophecies of the Spirit, the prophecies by the Spirit, demand that Jesus must come again. All those prophecies were written in the Bible. The word of God was written by the inspiration of the Spirit of God, and they all demand that he must come again. The program for Israel and for the nations, they demand that Christ must come again. God has a program for Israel, and that program has not been fulfilled yet. And because of that program that God has for Israel, that all Israel must be saved. They are not saved yet. He's coming back. And when he comes back, they will receive him as their Messiah, as their Christ, as their Lord, as their Savior. All that program of God for the children of Israel demands that he must come again. In Romans chapter 11, Romans 11, I'm reading from verse 26. And so all Israel shall be saved, as it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Israel. That has not happened yet. It must happen. Not only that, the plan of God for the church demands that Christ must come again. God has a plan for the church, and because that plan is yet to be fulfilled, that plan must be fulfilled. That demands that Christ must come again. What's the plan of God for the church? In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, reading from verse 51. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. Then he goes on to say, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Give me a good amen. All that demands that Christ must come again. Christ will return. He'll come for you. He'll come for me. He'll come for the church. And then he will give us a period of peace here on earth. Actually, the coming of the Lord is in two phases, in two parts. Number one, he'll come in the rapture to take the saints away. Then the sinners will be left over here in the world. I pray you'll not be a sinner. I can't hear you, Delta. I pray the Lord will save your soul. He will change your life, so that when the Lord will come, you'll be among the people that will go with the Lord in Jesus' name. That's point number one, the revelation of a sure return. I'm coming back to Revelation chapter 1. Revelation chapter 1, and I'm reading again from verse 7. Revelation chapter 1, we're looking at verse 7. It says, behold, he cometh with the clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all the kindreds of the earth shall wail, shall cry, shall scream, shall lament because of him. Even so, amen. That talks about the response. That talks about the reaction at the time when he comes. Point number two, the response and the reaction to his sudden return. He'll return suddenly, and then the people will cry. The people will wail. The question is why? If you look at that chapter one, look at that again. If you don't have your Bible, I'll read, pay attention. It says in that chapter 1 verse 7, after he has said, behold, he cometh, and he cometh with the clouds, and every eye shall see him. And now he tells us two parts of the people that will see him. He says, they which pierced him. They which pierced him. That's the first group. Those are the Jewish people. Those are the Israelites. And then he talks about his second part, and all the kindreds of the earth. Those are the Gentiles. Those are the nations. And he says, they will cry. They will wail. Now, let's look at Israel. Why will Israel cry? Why will Israel wail? Because now Christ has come. And when he comes, and then they see him, because it says every eye shall see him, they'll suddenly realize the one we pierced, the one we crucified, the one we said let his blood be upon us, is our Savior, is our Messiah, is a Redeemer, is the one that actually came to bring us the good news of salvation. And then we crucified him. They will weep for sorrow. Look at Zechariah chapter 12, I'm reading from verse 10. Zechariah chapter 12 verse 10, and I will pour upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplication, and they shall look upon him whom they have pierce the Jewish people, the Israelites, I'll pour upon them the spirit of grace and the spirit of supplication, of prayer. They will call upon him. They say, we didn't know that you are the Savior. We didn't know you are the Messiah. How could we do that? We crucified you. And then it says over here is a spirit of supplication, and they shall look upon him whom they appears, and they shall mourn for him as one mourneth for his only son, and shall be in bitterness for him as one that is in bitterness for his firstborn. It says, in that day shall there be a great mourning in Jerusalem as the mourning of Adad Rimmon in the valley of Megiddon. And then he goes on to say how they will mourn family by family apart. And then he tells us there'll be salvation for them. Look at chapter 13, verse 1. In that day there shall be a fountain open to the house of David and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem for sin and for their uncleanness. Look at verse 6. In verse 6 it says, and one shall say unto him, what are these wounds in thine hands? That's when he comes again. They will see the mark of the nail in the hand, in the feet, and the piercing of the side, what he bore for them. And then he shall answer, those with which I was wounded in the house of my friends. I came as a friend, I came as a savior, but because you didn't understand, that's why you crucified me. And then verse 9 tells us that they will be saved. And then the latter part of that verse 9, I will say, it is my people, and they shall say, the Lord is my God. On the one hand, the Jewish people, they'll cry, they'll mourn, they'll wail, because now they see Christ, that they were the one that pierced him and the ones that crucified him. Now the Gentiles too, they'll cry. Why will the Gentiles cry? Remember, at this time the church would have been raptured, caught up to heaven, and then there'll be the time of the great tribulation, and the Gentiles will cry. What cry will they have? Revelation chapter 6, I'm reading from verse 14. Revelation chapter 6, and we're looking at verse 14. And the heavens departed as a scroll when it is rolled up together, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places, and the kings of the earth, these are the Gentiles, and the great men, these are the nations, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man, hid themselves in the cave, in the dens, and in the rocks of the mountains, and said to the mountains and to the rocks, fall on us. They'll have the fear, because now he comes as king to reign. He comes as king to rule, and he comes with a rod of iron, and he'll break all the pots with the rod of iron. Hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb, for the great day of his wrath is come, and you shall be able to abide. That's why they will wail, that's why they will mourn. Those are the Gentiles. But if you are part of the people of God, I pray you'll be part of the people of God. Are you there? I say you'll be part of the people of God. If you're part of the people of God, when the rapture takes place, you would have gone. And then you'll be with the Lord, and you will reign with him forever and ever in Jesus' name. Somebody will say amen. We have looked at revelation of a sure return, because Jesus Christ is coming again. And then we have seen the response and the reaction to his certain and to his sudden return. Now we come to point number three. We're looking at our readiness for the saints' rapture. Our readiness for the saints' rapture. Revelation chapter 1, I'm reading from verses 7 and 8. Behold, he cometh. Behold, he cometh. And I've told you already, the coming is in two parts. Part one, the rapture. The rapture of the saints. Part two is the second coming proper, that he comes to rule and to reign over the world. And he says, behold, he cometh. He cometh with the clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they which have pierced him. And all the kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him. Even so, amen. Verse 8, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, says the Lord, which is, and which was, and which is to come, the Almighty. The Almighty. He will do mighty things in your life today. Are you there? I said, he will do mighty things in your life today. How do we get ready? How do we get ready if the Lord is coming again? And we know he's coming again. Since the Lord is coming again, and the Lord will come at any time, he can come for the church any moment from now. What are we to do? Anything to do? We need to get ready. Look at chapter 24 of Matthew. Matthew chapter 24. And you see the words of the Lord Jesus Christ himself, so that you'll not just be at this time looking at and hearing about the revelation of Christ. It comes to you now as to what you are to do. You have something to do so that you'll be ready. I'll be ready. I said, I will be ready. Somebody there, I will be ready. Look at chapter 24 and verse 35. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. But, look at this, of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. Don't let anybody deceive you and set date and say, he cannot come now, because this must still happen, that must still happen. And set date, he will come at a particular year, a particular month, or a particular day. Here the Lord himself said, nobody knows the date, not even the angels of God in heaven, but the Father only. But, verse 37, as the days of Noah, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking. They were living to eat and drink. They didn't think about their soul. They didn't think about their salvation. They didn't think about repentance. They didn't think about meeting the Lord when he will come. All they wanted is, I need to work. I need to get money. I need to build. I need to have house. I need to have a marriage. I need to have food. I need to have this or that. They were living for the mundane things of the world. And it says they were marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. That's telling us he'll come suddenly. He'll come when many people are not watching. They're not ready. Look at verse 42. Watch therefore. Because he'll come suddenly. Watch therefore. He'll come unannounced. Watch therefore. It says watch therefore. For ye know not what hour your Lord doth come. Look at verse 44. And therefore be ye also. Tell me the word there. Tell me out loud. Be ye also ready. Be ye also ready. Underline that word in your Bible. Be ye also ready. I'll be ready. I said, I'll be ready. What are you there? You'll be ready in Jesus' name. It says, therefore, be also ready. For in such an hour as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh. You see that word there? ready. Getting ready. Getting ready. You'll be ready. I said you'll be ready. Am I talking to somebody there tonight? I said you'll be ready. You'll be ready in Jesus' name. Luke chapter 21. Luke chapter 21. I'm reading from verse 34. Luke chapter 21, verse 34. Take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and the cares of this life, so that they come upon you unawares, unprepared. For as a snare shall it come on all them that dwell on the face of the earth. Watch ye therefore, and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and stand before the Son of Man. What's that saying? Again, he's saying, be ready. I will be ready. Say that aloud. Say that again. I'll be ready. What do you do to be ready? How can you get ready? I'm going to help you to understand what you do. If you do this, you'll be ready. Before I tell you, anybody wanting to get ready over there? I said anybody there wanting to get ready? You'll get ready. When Christ will come, you'll go with him in Jesus' name. Ready, it starts with R. R, repent of all your sins. You know that's what it is? Because it's coming to take the sins away. Those who are saved, those who are born again, those who are children of God, those who have turned away from sin, and those who have turned to him as Savior, and they have said, Lord, save me. Lord, change my life. I want to be ready. Repent of all your sins. E, embrace his atoning sacrifice. No, that the works of your hand cannot save you. No, that all the good things you have done cannot save you. If you're going to be ready, you turn away from your sins, you repent of your sin, and then you embrace his atoning sacrifice. He said, I died for you. Embrace that. I paid the price of your salvation. Embrace that. And then he said, if you will call upon me, I'll save you. If you come out of darkness and come into the light and embrace what I've done for you, I will save you. R, tell me. R, tell me. Repent of all your sins. E, tell me. Embrace his atoning sacrifice. A, accept his all-sufficient salvation. Accept his all-sufficient salvation. There's no salvation in any other. It's in Christ. And he wants to give you that salvation now. And it's an all-sufficient salvation. Salvation for your soul. Salvation for your spirit. Salvation for your body. Salvation for everything concerning you. He saves you from sin. He relieves you from sickness. And he delivers you from oppression. And it's an all-sufficient salvation. Lord, I accept. Lord, I accept. Lord, I accept. And once you accept, it is yours in Jesus' name. I want to hear a delta amen. Ready begins with an R. Tell me, R. I repent. Say, I repent. Say it aloud, I repent. E, tell me what's E. Embrace his atoning sacrifice. Don't go and make another sacrifice. There's no other sacrifice. He's done the sacrifice. Embrace that atoning sacrifice. A, tell me. Tell me, tell me. Accept his all-sufficient salvation. D, dedicate your life to active soul winning. Dedicate your life to active soul winning. As you are saved tonight, go tell another person. as you are forgiving tonight, go and tell another person. As you come into the kingdom of God tonight, go and tell another person. He said, go home, go back home to your friends and tell them how good the Lord has been to you, and the Lord has had compassion upon you. He will heal you tonight. I said, He will heal you tonight. Then you go and tell somebody back at home and give your testimony. He will deliver you tonight. Give me a good amen. He will roll your mountains away today. He will wipe your tears away today. And then you dedicate yourself to active soul winning. I'll tell other people. I'll tell other people. I'll tell other people. I meet this one at school. I'll tell him. I meet other one in the market. I'll tell her. I meet them in the bus. I'm going to tell them. I dedicate my life to active soul winning. Why? Yield in absolute surrender. Yield in absolute surrender. Not my will, but your will. Not my word, but your word. Not my way, but your way. I yield myself. I surrender myself. I belong to Jesus from today. I belong to Christ today. I belong to my Savior from today. I don't belong to Satan anymore. I don't belong to those evil spirits anymore. I don't belong to all those societies anymore. I surrender. Somebody there, I surrender. Somebody there, I surrender. Somebody shout out. Yield to Him in absolute surrender. R, tell me. Repent of all your sins. E, tell me. Embrace His atoning sacrifice. A, tell me. Accept His all-sufficient salvation. D, tell me. Dedicate your life to active soul winning. Why? Tell me. Yield to Him in absolute surrender. You know, if you do that, that's being ready. You'll be ready. I said you'll be ready. Somebody there getting ready. Where are you? I'll be ready. Where are you there? Where are you there? I'll be ready. When Christ will come, you'll not be left behind, in Jesus' name. Tonight, He will forgive your sin to get you ready. But you must repent. You must embrace that atoning sacrifice. And you must accept that all-sufficient salvation. And then dedicate yourself to serve the Lord. Active service, active soul winning. And then saying, I'm following after the Savior. I'm following after the Lord. And I yield to Him. I yield to Him in absolute surrender. Somebody there will yield to Jesus today. Somebody there is yielding to Jesus today. What is he there? What is she there? Amen. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heads bowed and eyes closed. You want to get ready, and you know what it stands for to get ready. I repent, I repent, I repent. And you're turning away from your sin. And you're saying, yes, Lord, I am here. Yes, Lord, I am here. I'm turning away from sin. I'm repenting from my sin. I'm embracing your sacrifice. I accept your salvation. I dedicate myself to you and to your service. And I'm yielding to you completely and entirely in absolute surrender. If you are repenting, you are getting ready. You don't want to be lost when Christ will come. You don't want to perish when Christ will come. Anywhere you are, you raise up your hand. You say, yes, Lord, I'm here. Yes, Lord, I'm here. Yes, Lord, I'm here. I want to be ready when He comes. I will not perish. I will not perish. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in you, that whosoever, the Lord is looking for you. The Lord is searching for you now, that you'll get ready. You repent of all your sin. Where are you? You raise up your hand. Where are you? Raise up your hand there. If you're raising up your hand, you will stand up. If you're raising up your hand, you'll stand up. You want to be ready. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you there. God bless you there. You're raising up your hand, you'll stand up. You'll say, yes, I'll be ready. Yes, I'll be ready. I repent. I turn away from all my sins, and I accept the atoning sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ. I embrace it. It is mine. Lord, I believe tonight. Where are you? You will stand up wherever you are. Stand up there. Stand up there. Stand up there. And while you you stand up there and say, Lord, I surrender myself to you. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him. In his presence I'll daily live. I quit all my sin. I quit all those evil things. I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ right now. Raise up your hand and stand up. And while you're standing up, tell the Lord, I will not go back to my sin. I'll not go back to Satan. I'll not go back to any evil. I believe the Lord. He died for me. I accept that sacrifice. I accept that salvation. I accept his offer right now. I dedicate myself to the Lord. And I'm going to yield to him and to his will, to his word, to his way, all the rest of my life. Tell the Lord, Lord, save me. Lord, save me. Lord, change my life. I dedicate myself to you from now on. In Jesus' name we pray. Keep up that hand as I pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you right now. We know you are a mighty God, and we know that you have given us the promise that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. I pray for all these who are standing up and who are raising up their hands and they're saying, Lord, I surrender. Lord, I yield myself, my life, my totality, my entirety unto Christ. I pray, forgive them in Jesus' name. Save them in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord, from this day, they'll be conscious of the coming of the Lord, and they'll be ready every time as they are connected with Christ, even from now on, in Jesus' name. Give them the assurance that their sins are forgiven. Give them the assurance that their names are written in the book of life in heaven. And I pray, Lord, they'll never be the same again. That new life, eternal life, give to every one of them. And when Christ shall come, they'll not be left behind, but they'll go with the saints when the saints go marching in. Confirm it in their lives, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Another Delta, amen. Keep on standing. Our counselors are there. They'll attend to you very briefly. Don't go home yet. And now we're going to pray with you after this counseling period. We're calling on our pastor, Pastor Jude, the state overseer of Delta State, to please help us during this counseling time.
Please, in all the pavilions, let our workers quickly get to those people now. You give them the slip. Please, you help them to write if they can't write, but those that can write, you give them the biro. You write your name, then your address, your contact, and then your cell phone number. Please write in capital letters. Write clearly your address now that you are born again. You are getting ready for his coming. You are a child of God. The information you will give us is nothing but the truth. Your name correctly written, your address, then your cell phone number. It must be 11 digits. Please let all our workers, as you've been divided in all the pavilions, do that quickly. Move up to where they are, give them the decision slip, and after filling, give them the converse package. You will see in that package a pastor's letter, and it gives you all information about the address of our branches nearest to you. Please, let's do that very fast, counselors. I'm not seeing you moving fast. Please, in the pavilions where you are, choristers are joining us, but let all our workers, every worker now, joins the counseling session. All workers in that pavilion where you are, please, we do that very fast before our pastor comes to pray and then declare the miracle of God upon your life tonight. So please do not go yet. Miracle prayer is coming. So our pastors, assist us. There will be banquet in all our region headquarters this coming Sunday here in Warri at Deco, then in all our regional headquarters There's going to be banquet by 3 p.m. Please make sure you are there. Please, let's do this very fast, our workers. Very quickly, after filling the comfort slip, you give them the comfort package. Collect back the slip from them and then give them the comfort package. Please, our pastors, assist. Make sure in all the pavilions our workers are doing what we have told them to do. Move up. Please, if you've not filled the comfort slip, raise up your hand so that they can see you. Raise up your hand if they've not reached you where you are. Raise up your hand. Those of you that surrendered your life to the Lord, want him to help you to get ready for his coming. The Lord is coming. All the prophecies, all the predictions the Lord gave us, pointing to his sudden coming in rapture, we are seeing them fulfilling before our eyes. So this is the time to get ready. And that is the great revelation that the Lord has brought to us tonight, making us to be ready for his sudden coming. So please, I see our choristers moving. Please move very fast. If you want to assist us, join in the pavilions, please. Our workers there already, be very fast. Our pastor is waiting, ready to pray for us. Release the power of God's miracle upon you. You will never remain the same. The showers of blessing will come upon you and follow you. You will remain unconquerable. The Lord is ready to touch you at that point of your need, at that point ailing your body. Miracle, healing, deliverance, breaking of yokes. Get ready. Please be very fast. Our choristers, please, those of you that are moving now, get into the pavilions very fast. Very fast. Very fast. Please raise up your hand if they've not given you the slip. If you raise up your hand and the pastor pray for you, you have given your life to the Lord Jesus, you want to be a child of God, ready for his coming, so that when the Lord comes, he will not catch you unawares. It will not take you unawares. We have seen the fulfillment of all the prophecies given concerning his first coming. Everything fulfilled. The Lord has come and he has gone to come back again, and the angels confirmed it, that this same Jesus, which has gone into heaven, shall also come in like manner. And our responsibility is to get ready. So please fill the form. That will help us to get back to you and help you to remain strong in that decision. The devil will never confuse you again. Nothing will deceive you again. Nothing will make you not to be ready. So that the day the Lord comes and the roll is caught up yonder with the saints, you will be there. Please be very fast. Our counselors, please be very fast. Please raise up your hand if you've not been located, if you've not gotten the comfort slip. Our counselors, you retrieve the comfort slip and give them the comfort package. There is contained in that package the letter from our Father in the Lord, praying for you to receive the blessing of heaven, the blessing of salvation, the blessing of deliverance, and then the readiness for his coming. Ultimately, the Lord taking you to heaven to live with him forever and ever with his saints. Please, let's fill the forms quickly. Our counselors, if you are true, you wave your hand at me. Please help them to write. Our pastors, ensure that the forms, the comfort sleep is filled properly, and then we collect them back. All our pastors in all the pavilions as we are distributed. Please receive. I'm waiting for you. If you have filled the form, you have given them the Converse package, please you indicate if we are through in that pavilion. To my right here, and then in the front, you wave your hand. A pastor will pray for you. Miracle is coming. You will not go home with that problem that has challenged you before today. A miracle is awaiting you. Can I hear you shout amen? These showers is a signal of showers of blessing from heaven. Something good is coming your way. So please fill the forms quickly. Our counselors, please. We are waiting for you. If we are filled in sleep, if we are done with that, please wave your hand at me. Let me see you. Please, let's be very fast. Let's be very fast. Let's be very fast. Please help them. Those that cannot write, you help them. Let them spell their names correctly. And then their addresses, their contacts, 11 digits, cell phone number. Please write legibly in capital letters, preferably. If you are true, please wave at me. If you are true, wave at me. Apostles. Okay, in this pavilion. Yes, what about this side? This side. Okay. What about here? Very close to the pulpit. Have we collected the slips? All right. What about the pavilion in my front here? Wave your hand if we have collected the Converse slip and you have given them the Converse package. What about the people here? Have we collected? All right. Get ready. The miracle of God is coming upon you. After the pastor's prayers and the amen, he said, it is done. I say, it is done. That pastor is already here.
Praise the Lord. Somebody waiting for miracle there, I say, praise the Lord. The Lord will touch you. There's power in that name. Authority in that name. There's anointing in that name. And when you hear the final amen, you check up yourself, the miracle will have been deposited in your body. Your blind eyes will open and see. Those deaf ears will hear tonight in Jesus' name. Those who are lame, you came walking on crutches, or you came, you were brought here on a stretcher, or you are in a wheelchair. When you hear that name mentioned, his healing will come to you immediately. Goiter will vanish away. That hunchback will vanish away. Cancer will be healed immediately. Whatever the challenge may be or the mountain in your life, the Lord is taking it away right now. Where are you there? Can you raise up your hand? Then you lay the other hand on yourself. And when you hear the final amen, check up, it will be there. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for Jesus who came and who is coming again. We thank you for Jesus alive, who is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We thank you for Jesus, Alpha and Omega. Thank you for Jesus, who is the beginning and the ending. Thank you for Jesus, who has all power in heaven, all power on earth. We thank you for the Jesus who said, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am in the midst of them. And we know you are here tonight. You are here to do what you have always done, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Touch your people tonight in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that every problem carried by anybody there, all those problems will receive solution tonight. All those mountains will move away tonight in Jesus' name. Manifest your power, heal and deliver everyone in Jesus' name. That insanity, I command you, spirit of madness, come out in Jesus' name. Spirit of epilepsy, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. All those strange voices, I silence those voices right now. Come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have anything crawling in their body, walking about in their body, afflicting them and attacking them. I command that afflicting spirit come out in Jesus' name. I pray, Lord, for those who have any pain in the body, pains in the general, in the joints, on the back, in the bone, anywhere. I command your pain and suffering and sickness come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have incurable diseases. Lord, there's no incurable disease with you. Every mountain you are going to move away. Every chain you are going to break. Every work of the devil you are going to destroy. I command those incurable diseases be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have cancer. I pray the Lord will touch them right now. Cancer, be healed in Jesus' name. Ulcer, be healed in Jesus' name. That dry cough, that tuberculosis and coughing of blood, I command you right now, be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have asthma, they cannot breathe well because something is holding their breath, be healed in Jesus' name. That tumor in your body, I command, come out in Jesus' name. Fibroid, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Elephantiasis there, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those kidneys that are not functioning, come alive in Jesus' name. And the lungs, come alive in Jesus' name. Diabetes, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. High blood pressure, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are deaf and dumb. I command right now those deaf ears begin to hear. Those dumb tongues speak out in Jesus' name. Lord, touch their eardrums. Touch their vocal cords. Receive your miracle of hearing and speaking in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are blind. Glaucoma, I command you, you have no right to stay there. Come out in Jesus' name. Cataract, I command you, be cleared away in Jesus' name. The blindness, the covering of your sight, or the dimness of sight, be healed in Jesus' name. Those who have withered hands, stretch out the hand, be made whole in Jesus' name. Those who have one leg shorter than the other, stretch out that leg, that short leg, grow out in Jesus' name. And those who have broken bones, I pray that the hand of the Lord will touch those broken bones. Be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have a stroke or they have polio, whatever it may be, or lameness, I command the power of God will come upon you right now. Receive the strength. Receive the power. Be made whole in Jesus' name. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. Lord, set your people free. To my left, freedom. To my right, freedom. At the back, freedom. In front of me, freedom. Receive your healing. You are delivered in Jesus' name. Receive your miracle. The Lord has set you free. You are free. You are healed. You are delivered. Lord, confirm it upon everyone. In Jesus' name I pray. Praise the Lord, it's there. It's there. Check up. You've got your miracle. You've got your miracle. You'll do what you are not able to do before. You are healed. You are delivered.
It has happened. As you see the miracle there, you shout hallelujah. It has happened. The miracle is on you there. The hand of the Lord has touched you. Check up yourself. The healing has taken place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It will get to you there. It will get to you there. Please, Akeselos, please bring them out. Please, check up. The miracle is everywhere. The prayer is on you. Everywhere in all the pavilions, the hand of the Lord is there. The miracle is on you now. Check up yourself. Do what you cannot, what you are not able to do before. And then bring them out. Begin to come out. Please come. We want to hear your testimony. Bring them out. Our counselors, help them. Check them up in all the pavilions. The Spirit of God has moved mightily. The power of God has touched you. The answer to the prayer of the man of God is on you. Open that blind eyes now. Rise up from that wheelchair now. Come out. Begin to step out. And then we shall hear your testimony tonight. Come out. Please help them to come out. In all the pavilions. In the front. By my right side. By my left side. Behind. Check up yourself. Don't be in a hurry. You see what the Lord has done. You see the healing taking place that has taken place. Diabetes is gone. That ulcer is gone. Fibroid is gone. That gutter is gone. That swelling has disappeared. Stand up on your leg now. Stroke is gone. That lameness is gone. Yes, keep coming. Bring them out. Check up yourself. You are healed. You are delivered. Open that eyes. Stand up. Come out from that wheelchair. Pastors, our overseers, please come and help us. Confirm, test them, and bring them out. Help them to come. We shall hear the testimony of what the Lord has done this special day. The rain of miracle came down. The showers of blessing touched everyone. Healing has taken place. Deliverance, breaking of yokes. The Lord has touched you. Please do not hide it. It is there. It is done. Come. Your own is there. Please bring them out. Help them to come out. Help them to come out. Oh yeah, bring them out. Counselors, help them there in all the pavilions. Check them up, help them. It is done. The healing has taken place. The miracle has taken place. The deliverance, the yoke broken. The swelling is gone. That lame person, the blind eyes, the deaf and dumb have been touched. Help them, touch them, and help them to come out. Please help them to come towards the
pulpit area here. Please help them to come. Help them to come. Help them to come. Help them to come. Take up yourself. The Lord has touched you. You cannot go back home without challenge, without kidney problem. You cannot go back without challenge. The miracle of God's power tonight has touched you. You come out. You tell us. Let us hear what the Lord has done. Please help them to come out. Please bring them. I want to listen to the testimony quickly. Our time is running. Our pastors, please help them. Our overseers, help them. Bring them out quickly. Please bring them, bring them, bring them. Yes. Yes. The miracle is there. It's on you. The hand of the Lord is there on you. The power of God has touched you. The problem has been knocked out. The problem is gone. Please help them to come quickly. Yes, our counselors, help them. Please guide them up to this way. God bless you as you come. Please help them to come. Help them, help them. Make the way for them, make the way for them. Please make a way for them. We want to see them come nearer here so that we can listen to their testimonies. Please help them. Help them. Help them. Bring them. Bring them. Bring them. Help them to come to this canopy here, please. Apostles, help us. Overseers, help us. Regional overseers, please help us. Please, if we have tested them, please come. We get them the microphone. Please, if we have confirmed, let's know the first to testify. If we have confirmed, yes, the miracle is there. It is happening. It is happening. The Spirit of God is still moving. It is happening. Join them. Apostles, please help us. Our group pastors, then overseers, help us to interview them and then confirm. Confirm what has taken place. Confirm what has taken place. Confirm what has taken place. Then you let us know. If you confirm the testimony, then we give them the microphone. Please help them to come out. Make a way for them, please. Behind, let's help them to come. Please. Our ushers, you can help us. Take a step of faith. Check up. Confirm the miracle. Overseers, please. Want to listen to the testimonies? Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Data will never remain the same. The miracle is here. Do not doubt it. It has taken place. You just come out. Apostles will help you to come out. Our overseers, please help us to confirm it. And then we listen to the testimony. Please, if we are ready to go, please make a way for them, dear. Those behind this place, help them to come. Please, if we are confirmed, you let me know. While we are waiting, please, we are waiting for you. Pastor Ross, let's have the microphone for the testimony here. Praise the Lord. While we are waiting for those to give us the testimony, I want to inform you that our state governor, Senator Dr. Arthur Ifan Yokowa, was ably represented here tonight by the chaplain of Delta State, that's Venerable Charles Asemina, and then Reverend Professor Oke Akokutu, the executive secretary, Delta State Pilgrims Welfare Board. They are here tonight. They represented the governor of Delta State. That's to tell you that the governor of our state gave his support for this Bible study. Put your hands together for Jesus. Please, we are waiting for the testifiers. Please, we listen to the testimony now.
Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. My name's Anthony Kechojo Oma Egbenyo. I came here for a particular purpose. To the glory of God, I have gotten what I came for, and fully so. Since November last year, I've been suffering from what they call severe cervical spondylosis. And I've been managing it until May before I started taking true treatment. I had to report to my church because of the severity. That very night, my regional overseer prayed for me. It looked like he just struck the snake on the neck. And then about 2 months later, my state overseer here prayed for me also. It was like he just sent it to a slumber. But today I came with a determination. I threw away my collar before I came down here. Yours faithfully, I am totally healed of spondylosis. I am strong. I can move my neck as I have not been doing before now. Praise the name of the Lord.
Put your hands together for Jesus. Only those in the medical profession will understand what our brother is talking about. That the Lord touched him. The thing was going to affect his spinal cord. But look at him turning the neck. Strong, standing. Put your hands together for Jesus.
Praise the Lord. My name is Edebe Ogunele Precious from Isoko Region. In 2014 December, I had an accident at the front of my house, and since then I had dislocation in the leg. The leg was very swollen for about 3 months. I couldn't move. I went for x-ray in 2015, and they also massaged the leg, but at times it goes and it's also come back. But today, as a man of God was praying, I was praying in my heart, and as he prayed, by the grace of God, I felt a sharp pain on my leg, and by now I can bend the leg backward. I can do things I no longer do with the leg. Praise the Lord.
Put your hands together for Jesus. The Lord touched that leg, and she can bend it now. She stood up, the pain gone. Yes.
Praise the Lord. I want to thank my GS. Daddy Oshé. Thank you, Daddy. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My name is Sister Esther Abbas. I came all the way from done. I have been looking for my GS. Then I said, this time around, let me come to Abo, which is my own place. Anytime he goes to Kaduna, I followed him down to Kashia. I didn't get my miracle. He came again. I followed him to Kafanchan.
Keep coming, keep coming.
I didn't get my miracle.
I told you the miracle is there.
I was in Kaduna. I came now all the way. Okay. Okay. Now, I said now, I learned that my GS is coming to Agbo. I said I will look for my GS. Now GS, I was told that he came to Warri. Okay. When my mother died, I was told that GS came to Warri. There was nobody to follow me to hold the occasion. I now said no problem. But I thank God today, I've been in deeper life for years. For a good 10 years, I've been suffering like this. The problem is that I can't stand very well. I can't stand. Anytime I stand, I would like to sit down. I do walk with this stick. But today, I'm no more walking with this stick. Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
Sir,
she exercised faith. And she can stand now with the walking stick. The Lord has done it.
The Lord.
Before the next testimony, please be informed that today's message is ready here. You can get a copy, just 300 naira. The CD is already made for you. Get a copy before you go. 300 naira only, the DVD of today's message. We'll listen to the next testimony.
Praise the Lord. My name is Mene Precious. I'm from Jedo Group of District. By the grace of God, I'm born again. My testimony is good like this. Since I was born, this my year, I've been paining me 15 years. 15 years. It's only when someone stand close to me that we hear the person bringing out pause. We have went to so many clinics, but no solution. We have used so tablets, no solution. So after last GS coming, that GS come. So I came here, me and somebody, when I tried my GS exam, I came. When I came here, I see that I will not go without getting my miracle. So after GS program, till now, on the 6th of June, since now, I've not of any ear pain. Even I can even stand very far. When you talk, I can hear you. Praise the Lord.
Put your hands together for Jesus. Did you hear her? That was 6th June. We told you that day that the prayer of our pastor has done the miracle. Believe it. And she believed it.
Praise the Lord. Gladys is my name. I'm Gladys Tennyson, Obotwari. I want to testify that God has done a lot in my life. Today, God delivered me from Hashma problem, which is solved. Praise the Lord!
Hashma gone. And the Lord has taken it away forever. It is to no but more be
praise
Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord! I am here to testify for the goodness of God upon my life. I am suffering for the ulcer more than 5 years. Even before when I came, anytime that the rain touches me, I've been feeling pain all over my body. Even today, it called rain beat me, and I started feeling the pain. But the moment I come here, the ulcer disappeared. All the pain over my body has gone, and I have a song to render for the glory of God. Saloda Bira! Saloda Bira! Ninu gbogbo alagbara laaye ko so ba bere Oluwa. Praise the Lord.
Us are gone.
Praise the Lord.
Us are gone. No more. You are free forever. Praise the Lord. Put your hands together for Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
We listen to this testimony.
Praise the Lord. My testimony is that since I was small, Because somehow I always like moving close to television, so it had always affected my eyes, and I will not see clearly. It even came to a point that around 4 p.m. from till 4 p.m. till down into the night, because I was using glasses before. If I remove the glasses, I'll just still miss all around. But tonight, when the GS prayed and I opened my eyes, I saw that my eyes was perfectly clear. Praise the Lord.
Put your hands together for Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
We are going to test him now.
The boy here is my son. And we all know that at home, since when he was a little boy, he cannot see very far, except something is very close to his eyes. But after the prayer of our pastor tonight, the Lord has touched his eyes. Now he can see things at a far distance. His eyes are clear. Now praise the Lord!
That's the Father confirming the miracle of sight restoration. Put your hands together for Jesus. We are giving him something to read now.
Verse 11. Now these are the children of the province that went up out of the captivity of those which had been carried away.
Put your hands together for... You remember what he said, from 4 p.m. till the following day, he will not see. They see him now. Another testimony.
My name is Goodluck Accordion. I want to share my testimony. Since last year, I get one accident when I they come from Lagos to Warri. So I can't vex, I don't treat the hand again. I can't leave her like that. But today, as I can't come the program today, as the pastor, as the man of God, they pray, I can't defeat the hand of God in the that my hand where they pay me. So I can't get signs, say something. The hand of God touched me. So now I just want to give God all the glory that the hand of God have touched me, that I've saved from that accident.
Salvation, confirmation of God's touch in his life, touching the accident and the pain. Thank God for that double miracle, salvation and healing. Praise the Lord. We listen to another testimony.
Praise the Lord. I should put it to my mom. Okay. Praise the Lord. My mom here, for over 3 years now, she have a heart problem. So we have been going to many places. But as we are coming here today, she cannot walk with all by herself. But I thank God now that she walked all the way from that place to this place. So I believe that the miracle is done.
The miracle has taken place. The mama now walked from the pavilion down to this place. Mama, walking. Put your hands together for Jesus. Mama, you are healed. You are whole forever and ever in Jesus' name.